Today our lesson is about the seasons of India. There are four seasons in India. First one is winter, summer, advancing monsoon, retreating monsoons. Advancing monsoon is also called as southwest monsoon season. And retreating monsoon season is also called as northeast monsoon. Here, first we discuss about the winter. In the winter, the temperature reduces from the mid-November to February. The January is the coldest month. The temperature is very low in the January. All over the India, in many parts of India. Of course, sometimes in the winter season, the temperature reduces 10 degrees below in many parts of India. But when we compare to North India to South India, in Southern India, the temperature remains 20 degrees. It doesn't go below the 20 degrees. So what is the difference between the North India and South India in the variation of temperature? Here, the coastal climate is affecting the South India. It is increasing the temperature in the Deccan Plateau, especially. But in the North India, Himalayas are there and cold winds are coming from the Asian parts. So the temperatures are very low in the northern plains, in the Gangetic valleys, etc. Look at this map. This map is showing India's average temperature in January, in the winter. Let us see the temperatures in the northern India are lower than the temperatures in the southern parts of India. Here, the southern parts of India, the temperature is 20, 25, and here. But here in the North India, 10 degree also there. In the winter, we experience clear sky, low humidity, and cool breezes. It reduces the temperatures in the parts of India. And also, we have to know about the western disturbances. What are the western disturbances? The western disturbances, these are the depressions, cyclonic depressions coming from the Mediterranean Sea to the India. These are called western disturbances. Due to these western disturbances, we get low to moderate rainfall in the northern plains, the northern plains of India. And these are very helpful, these western disturbances are very helpful to boon for the crop of wheat in the rabi season. India lies in the trade wind zone of northern hemisphere. The northeast trade winds, actually they are dry, but as they are blowing over the sea, they picks up moisture from the ocean. It gives rainfall to the Coromandel coast in Tamil Nadu. Actually, Coromandel coast in Tamil Nadu doesn't get rainfall from the southwest monsoons. In the general rainy season, it will not get the rainfall. But here, in the southeast monsoon period, we get the rainfall for the Coromandel coast. Next, summer. In the summer, when we move from the south to north in India, the average temperature increases. Actually, what will be happen? The Tropic of Cancer is passing through the center of India. It divides India into two zones. The southern part of Tropic of Cancer lies in the tropical zone. The northern part of Tropic of Cancer lies in the temperate zone. Generally, the temperature in the tropical zone will be more than the temperate zone. But here what happening? The temperature in the tropical zone is more than the tropical zone. So what is the reason for this? Because in the South India, in the peninsula South, here the coastal climate is affecting South India due to the coastal climate. Coastal climate means, already I explained in the part 1, we get the equable climate. You know the land and water relationship is there. Sea bridges, land bridges, you know that. Due to the sea bridges, land bridges, the temperature is moderate in the southern India. So automatically when we compare to northern India, the southern Indian temperature is lower than northern. Temperature increases to 37 degrees centigrade in the northern plains. And in mid-May, the temperature increases 41 degrees centigrade to 42 degrees centigrade, especially in the northwestern parts of India and northern plains. Northwestern parts of India means desert. There is a thar desert is there. Here, and the temperature should not downs to 20 degrees centigrade.
Look at the map. This map is showing the India's average temperature in the month of May in the summer. Just you observe the temperatures in North India and in South India. The temperatures in North India are more than the temperatures in the South India. When we move from the South to North, the temperature increases.
We experience one important thing. In the summer, there is a dry and hot winds. These winds are called low winds are appeared in the northern plains. They are very dusty, sandy, and it leads to the sandstorms in the northern plains. Okay, end of the summer. At the end of the summer, we experience pre-monsoon showers. Not much rainfall. End of the summer season, we get pre-monsoon showers. They are also called as bursting monsoon. They are occurred suddenly with the thunders and lightning. Sudden rainfall at the end of summer season. These are very helpful in ripening of early mangoes and other crops. These pre-monsoons are very helpful, especially in the Deccan Plateau. And these are called mango showers in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, because they are helping in the ripening of mangoes.
Before going to advancing monsoons, we should know how the low pressure and high pressure are created.
More temperature, when it receives more solar energy, automatically the air rises up, low pressure is created. At the same time, high pressure is on the ocean, because there is a weak solar radiation. Here in the winter, weak solar radiation towards the land. So the cold land surface is there. Hot land surface is here. Cold land surface is here. But now, here the temperature is
much. It is more than the land. So here low pressure is created. So pressure and temperature are opposite to each other.
Advancing monsoons. This season is also called southwest monsoon period. So bulk of rainfall we get from the southwest monsoons. Bulk of rainfall we get from the southwest monsoon in India. So what is meant by monsoon? Monsoon, the word derived from Arab. It is Arabic word. It means season. Actually, Arabs named this. In olden days, the Arabs, they sailed towards India for their trade. They observed regular, systematic reversal of periodical reversion of winds. It means in the same time they are moving to that place and afterwards they are coming back to in the same period. And the period, periodically they are moving forward and they are moving backward. They observed and they used to sail these winds. They reached India easily with the help of these winds. So they named as monsoons.
Southeast trade winds, they blow towards the equatorial low pressure belt. When they reached the equator, suddenly they are deflected towards Indian subcontinent. From then, they are called as southwest monsoons. They are blowing from the southwest. So they are called southwest monsoons. Now, the southeastern monsoons, named as southwest monsoons. Why they are attracted toward the Indian subcontinent? The low pressure is created at the northern plains of India, and also the low pressure is created on the Tibetan plateau.
At the time of southwest monsoon period, low pressure is created here and high pressure is created over the ocean. Low pressure is created on the land, high pressure is created on the water. At the time of northeast monsoon period, it means retreating monsoon period, high pressure is created on the land, low pressure is created on the ocean. So these high low pressure and high pressure are shifting each other in different seasons. Southeast winds, actually they are in the port of trade winds. Southeast winds moves towards the equatorial low pressure belt. When they reach the equator, suddenly they are deflected. They turn towards Indian subcontinent because of low pressure belt created in the northern plains of India. As well as the low pressure belt created at the Tibetan plateau. The hot vertical currents. Created on the Tibetan plateau over the 9 kilometers above. So due to these two low pressure belts, the southeast winds dragged towards Indian subcontinent. Then they became as southwest monsoons. They came from southeast reached the equator, then they turn towards Indian subcontinent. When they turn towards the Indian subcontinent, they are called as southwest monsoons. Called as southwest monsoons. These southwest monsoons gives bulk of rainfall to India. And the Indian, what is that? Peninsula. The Indian Peninsula divides these winds into two branches. One branch is Arabian Sea branch. One branch is Bay of Bengal branch. The Bay of Bengal branch reaches the coastal areas of West Bengal and southern parts of Shillong Plateau. Then they are deflected along the Gangetic valleys. Over. Next, Arabian Sea branch. It moves towards the southern coast of India and then it turns towards north. These two branches meet India in the first week of June. This is called onset of monsoon. The two branches meet India in the first week of June is called onset of monsoon.
Here you see the two branches, Arabian Sea branch and Bay of Bengal branch. Bay of Bengal branch moves towards the coastal area of West Bengal and Bangladesh, and then it is deflected along the Indo-Gangetic Valley. The Arabian Sea branch moves towards the southern coast and then it moves towards north. Totally, these two branches, Arabian Sea branch, Bay of Bengal branch, meet the Indian continent in the first week of June. It is called onset of monsoon. They spread over, the two branches spread over entire India within 4 to 5 weeks.
These monsoons, entered into India. They spread the entire India, overall India, within 4 to 5 weeks. We get bulk of rainfall from these southwest monsoons. Retreating monsoons also called northeast monsoons. It is the returning of southwest monsoons called as retreating monsoons, northeast monsoons. Here, northeast monsoons give more rainfall to Coromandel coast than the southwest monsoons. Once the low pressure is created in the northwestern areas, now it shifts to south, to the Bay of Bengal. When the low pressure is created on the Bay of Bengal, the cyclonic depressions created over the Andamans and in Bay of Bengal. These cyclonic depressions, also called tropical cyclones, these tropical cyclones are very destructive. these cyclones disrupt the Indian eastern coastal plains. Such as Godavari Delta, Krishna Delta, Kaveri Delta, like that. And also they meet the Sundarban Delta and Bangladesh.
Equator, the equatorial zone, it has a low pressure belt. And then when we move towards north, there is a subtropical high pressure belt. And when we move to southward, subtropical high pressure belt is there. The trade winds moves from the high pressure, subtropical high pressure belt to low pressure belt, and here have subtropical high pressure belt to low pressure belt. These are called trade winds. Retreating monsoons, as they are blowing over the Bay of Bengal, they picks up moisture from the Bay of Bengal and it gives rainfall to the Coromandel Coast. This Coromandel Coast doesn't get rainfall from the southwest monsoons. Only with the help of southeast monsoons, with the help of retreating monsoons, it gets bulk of rainfall.
Here, the October-November is a transition period. It is changing period. The climatic conditions are changed from the hot wet to dry winter. Of course, the land is still moist. We can recognize the retreat of monsoons. The sky is very clear. The rise in the temperature. Due to the rise in the temperature and high humidity, the uncomfortable conditions are created to us. We call it as October heat. Traditional Indian seasons. According to the traditional calendar, a year is divided into 6 seasons. Each season it has 2 months, like Chaitram, Vaishakham, like that. And we are now following the Gregorian calendar. In this calendar, January, February, March, etc. are there. There is a slight difference between the North India to South India in the timing of this following calendar.